Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, it's the final. And we just need to update some bits and pieces. The map is Coruscant Landfill, and the mission is One Man's Trash. And if we go over to the table, we'll be able to have a look at it. So this is it. This is the final. And we're running well ahead of schedule. You can't argue with that. There we go. As if by magic, we'll make sure they get that the dice box. In dice cam space. What I'll do is we just let that play. I shall return.
Watch this on the recording later. Yeah.
I'm in a bit now.
I hate myself.
I like that plaque. Actually, I think it's going to be pretty cool either way, but I love that. I'd love to get one out of my last year's.
I've told my missus that I'll have to try and bring both back.
Yeah, he did, yeah. Too lazy to change it.
Did you take this list at Big Orbit?
I changed my command cards, but yeah, most of the list. Yeah.
No, don't forget you've got new stuff. I'll work around you guys.
Well, I'd rather look prettier than that. Trays anyway.
It's good. It's really not.
A shuffle. I can get set up in Kai as well. So you've got
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, buddy. Great playing,
Doc.
So the final round, 1 hour, 45 minutes, 105 minutes.
I know what you're doing. You're going to say, I don't even know what the score is. He would have won.
Can we get a picture?
I'm okay with it. I know you're still playing, but you've been called out. Make your move. And I had to call Tio over to watch you on this mission. He was holding crazy.
An hour 45, yeah, 105, yeah, cheers. How do I do this? Right, like stop.
Have you not been enough both today?
There we go. Thank you.
Oh, I hope this will continue to bring me strength in my moment of trial.
Do you want to run a scorecard again?
Yeah, if you can do that.
I don't suppose anybody can play some low Star Wars OST just in the background, just to push it over the top.
Yep.
Can you check if the score thing's on stream?
It is, yep, just at the bottom, yep. Let me know when you want the timer to start.
There's a cut.
Oh, we've got the timer on this one instead.
Yep, I need to know when to start it here. No, sorry. I'll mute myself when I'm shouting across the room.
glad to see you.
Yeah, yeah.
One, two.
Nice way to.
Is that way in the way, Rob?
Nice.
Too quiet, too loud?
No. Too quiet, I'd say.
Yeah, you're a bit
more. It's not going to be. Alright, so you have six activations to my six. So I will.
Are we ready, chaps?
We are ready.
Underway. Go.
We are underway. The final. The count is on. Robert Angel, come and join me on the chat.
I will be once I finish.
We will have a chat with the tournament organizer about how it's gone, and we'll do a bit of commentary, and we'll see what we see. So Alistair on the left, Rich Parks on the right. So let's have a quick rundown. Has anyone got I've got Rich's list. I need Alistair's list.
Well, only actually Jabba can't give a focus to the Rangers, so
Jabba can do,
and he'll move Greedo forward.
There we go. Thank you very much. So Alistair, the Alliance Rangers we saw, Gideon, Weequay Pirates, Greedo, Jabba, Onar, Temporary Alliance, and Black Market. It's a bit of a greatest hits of everything we've seen today. Against Rich's list, who we just saw, but in case I run down again, Diva Scheme, Shala, Jabba, Vinto, Gamoran Guard Elites, Gamoran Guard Elites, and Hired Guns. And someone trying to break in the building, by the sound of it. He's just that excited by the finals. We've got crowds of people pillaring him through the walls.
So when you get that first 2 points, because you just get an easy little kill. I've never had a chance to do it once today. This must be...
Yeah.
Yep.
So one man's trash. Coruscant landfill.
Thank you, sir. That's right. Are they both?
No.
I was
going to say, both
I was gonna say that's not. Like cool. Okay. That's his activation. Mm-hmm.
I lost to
Okay.
Here we go.
So this one will attack Adora.
So, Rich Parks, champion of last week's regional in Evesham, versus Alistair Scott, champion of last year's Curtain Games Southwest Regional. And the Nationals, of course, but we Curtain Games Regional, far more important to us anyway.
Pierce 1, plus 2 damage, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1 is 3 more damage, 5, and he'll hide.
And already the battle to get those doors open begins. Remember last year, Alistair, big fan of getting the doors open, early doors. Pardon the pun. I've got no one to talk to. Rob's going to be joining me.
Shadow's the only focus so far, right?
Yes. Can you do two attacks?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is it. This is.
It's just perform two attacks. It's not on a figure or any wording like that. So that would be two, pH two.
Yep.
PH two and high. So just two on the door.
Yep. One if I'll give them to you.
Yeah. It's a little hidden, like we talked about earlier. It's hidden.
Yeah, yeah.
Into being a little bit more of a
tricks as advised by
second attack.
Yeah.
Will be so that's four, so another two, and I'll use my hide from hidden to rehide.
Dig it.
Yep. Yeah. So it's re hidden and two throw on the door.
Sure.
Okay, so two four on the door. Two movement points left.
And now Vimto steps up to shoot the door.
I think I will go with
he's pointing at it too, which is always aesthetically pleasing.
I keep waiting for it to be a good thing. Just something like this. Better than drawing a card.
Dave Perks back in Rich Parks. It's controversial, Dave. I hope you're right. Well, I like Alistair too, but you know, someone from Devon winning a tournament in Devon. That's a nice kind of ring about it. Oh, here he is, the man himself. Tournament organizer Robert Angel. He's putting on his headphones. Now he's had to do a lot of difficult rules decisions today. And have you found Google, Rob?
Google's brilliant. Yeah.
You can pretty much get an answer for anything, can't you? I mean, if you look long enough. So, Alistair Scott, Rich Parks. Who's going to win, and how?
You couldn't call this one.
Well, you've got it. That's your job.
Well,
you're not allowed to have an opinion. You're the ref.
As TO, it's kind of yeah.
I think Alistair's going to win. Alistair won the Nationals.
Alistair did win the Nationals.
Did Rich beat Alistair last week, though? At the Regionals?
They did not play last
no,
week.
No, but he won the Regional. Alistair was also in the Regional.
True, yeah.
And of course, to be the best, you've got to beat the best.
Woo!
As Ric Flair would say. Excuse me. To be the man, you've got to beat the man. All that aside, though, you know, you don't win tournaments by getting lucky or through this many games. So they're both there on merit.
Absolutely. This could really go either way.
Well, I'm going to need you to pull out some stops. So at the moment, we've got the challenge. We've got the two doors into the trash compactor. Both we played this game ourselves not so long ago. You know, you've got to get those doors down.
This is true, yeah.
Let's shoot him. We've got Greedo lurking at the top in the tunnel behind this door. These doors are open at the top. And it looks like on the other end are hired guns.
It does look like both of them are planning on going through the...
They both want the trash compactor doors open. So what do you do? Do you ignore the mission and go for violence? Or do you play the mission and go for the points?
Really? It's a tough call. It's a tough call. I mean, Alistair's got numbers there, hasn't he? So
if you have a look at this, I mean, Alistair's rocking Rebels and Scumbags. So he's got Jabba, Weak-A-Pirates, HKs, Shyla, Temporary Alliance, C-3PO and Devious Scheme. Now, Shyla is a bit of a beast, as we found out. Went down earlier in the last game, but again, a Rich, a Devious Scheme, Shyla again, so it's a Shyla off. Jabba the Hutt, Vinto, Harita, Gamorrean guys, Gamorrean guys, and I had guidance. Both sides, of course, have Jabba. He'll probably sit at the back of the board and not do very much other than tell people where to go. In the last game, we were talking about the idea of the combat Jabba, the Jabba on a skateboard who gets up in someone's grill, starts bullying them, starts laying down the double damage. Nice, and sadly, I think it's a bit of a pipe dream, but it sounds so cool.
Well, you know, there's no time. Like, if you want to try that out.
Jabba on a skateboard, yeah.
Jabba on a skateboard, yeah.
Give it a go. The lubed up Jabba, just a slippery bastard, excuse my language. So here we see some dice. So one damage. Just going to try and blast that door, I imagine. First round of Imperial Assault, often quite a one for maneuvering. So the doors negate two every time and a 10 health each, but the door is gone. Alistair has blown the door. Bit of a deja vu to his final last year at this regional against Matt Watson, where shot the door early doors, not on this map, but got the door down. He said he wanted to get straight through. Now he's got a clear run at those crates now, Rob. So he can start either getting in there. There's only one really you can get in without going into the difficult terrain.
Hmm.
But that's an easy.
It's an a nice points. Way to build an easy early lead.
Yep, and he's stacking up the damage over here, but I mean, for the Gamorreans to do anything, they've got to get up and hit the door, which isn't good, it's not an optimum place for them to be, especially when the other door's now open.
Participation and a side of the prize to get eight. But I sort of prefer to be
Ah, so someone in chat room, thank you very much. Last week in the final, Rich ignored the crates and went just for the fight. May happen again, same map as last week's regional final. Early doors, pad pun. Early doors is a great pun, isn't it? I mean, that's if anyone's got a crate-related pun, you know, that's crate. That's crate. I can't think of any others. It's been a long day. So I reckon the chat room are back in Rich. Say it quietly, because you don't want to upset Alistair. He's an angry Canadian. I'm going to do that thing when I lean around the corner and just see.
Can we get a show of hands from the chat room? Who do you think is going to win at this stage?
Might be a bit hard because it's just text, Rob. We haven't paid for the emoticons yet. So, here we go. Whack in the door.
Boo.
Is that boo or boo worms? I think he's definitely saying boo worms. They were great puns, Dave. You did us proud in the quarters. I'd just say it's a miracle we're managing to get anything going up, but of course they bounce out to YouTube, bounce into the Twitch thing, they're lag free. If I told you how we were doing it, you know, dark arts and hope and two tin cans, pretty much anything we're managing to stream. Hey, so Al's beat backing, it's normal practice, buddy. I said, Rich beat, oh, I'm sorry to hear that. You should have come down to this, you could actually revenge this weekend. Dave's back in Alistair. Oh, it's been a big change of money in the Vegas market. I think I'm going to have to go off the fence and say I'm back in Rich. God help him if he lets me down. Damage deflected and a surge. Two damage. Pretty much the perfect roll for that.
I don't like my recorded voice. Oh, wrong headphones.
You like them in those headphones?
That's £7 on Amazon.
Now I'm sat here with the real tournament organiser, James Fox. How's it going, James?
Yeah, I'm alright, mate.
Is that a good day?
I'm tired.
It's tired. This is like the 12th event in a year. Running in February.
Yeah, we are broken.
Apart from Ollie, he's not really been here this weekend.
No, but he's working.
In a real job. How dare he?
It's Yavin next week as well, so that's going to break me.
Hey, you're going to Yavin?
Yeah, I'm trying,
lovely at
try,
time,
and,
yeah?
try and sort them out and make them organise it properly, but try my best.
Opinions on the stream may not match that of Curtain Games.
Yeah.
All my subsidiaries.
This does not represent us.
Here's your money on, James.
I don't know. Rich goes for the kill. Rich has bloodlust, and I think that may cost him sometimes. But to be honest, the bloodlust worked against me, so...
Against the Teesside Regional tomorrow.
Someone is. Alistair is.
Alistair, are you going to Teesside tomorrow?
Don't interrupt him.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. I think he's going...
driving overnight. He's driving all night to get to Teesside to play Imperial Assault.
That's dedication.
That's like the Kessel Run and that 9 billion parsec.
Yeah, I won't be getting up tomorrow, I don't think. I think I might have a long day. It's a good dice cam. It's better than the last one. Because we used a rubbish camera last time and it kept going out of focus.
Now so we're locked in.
Although I do miss Craig on the stream. He was quite entertaining.
Yeah, but our lawyers don't.
No. I think we had several cease and desist on that one.
Have a good drive tomorrow then. Anyone who is going to Teesside from Devon. Just the 8 hours overnight. That's crazy.
Yeah.
What if he wins this?
Not much happening.
Round two, not much. We've got some damage down here on Vimto.
I love Vimto.
I used to live on the street where Vimto was made.
Did you?
At Granby Row, Manchester. There's a sculpture.
Wow.
Curtain Games rule.
That's
damn right, Dave Parks.
Oh, God.
And San Dimas. Wild Stallion. Yeah. Wild Stallions rule.
Well, eventually I like to think that Curtain Games will redefine not only the gaming industry, but also life as we know it on this planet.
Sounds pretty good.
Yeah. We are Wild Stallions.
Wild Stallions.
We just need that one hit that brings the whole world together and we can stop this whole Trump,
God gave
Brexit
assault to you.
Thing. Not that.
It's Shiloh, not Vinto, thank you. It's a bit of glare on our camera and we're sat quite a way back so we don't distract them with our inane chatter. So Shiloh taken 7. She has 12. She has 5 remaining.
We've got the list. Have you gone through the list?
The list is here. We have gone through this. We've got them again.
I just want to look.
I think there's some interesting lists.
Well, I know Richard's Park list because he destroyed me with it earlier. I had one good play in the whole game. And that was it.
Is that the handshake?
We're going to get Rob back on the stream in a minute because I'm really good at talking.
Rob, come and get on the stream.
I think he's going to do a payment and then he'll get back on the stream.
He looks like he's eating a cake to me.
He does look like he's eating a cake.
We had some great cakes at our
events. It's a Yoda cake. That's excellent.
Ah, eat the cake you will. Slap you I will.
Right.
It's a pun from 2000.
So what's Luke? That's not Luke's not in the final.
Dave Perk says more fake tan. I'm sure that's a Trump reference. But
that does sound like a Trump reference. Right.
He's going to do jab with his Trump.
I haven't actually looked at Alistair's list at all. Rangers, Gideon, so the Rebel care package.
Nice amount of range with the weak ways and the Rangers.
No C3PO. Oh, yeah.
It can shoot quite a way. This ain't a map for shooting long distances.
No, it's not.
Apart from the top corridor, where we've got a hard gun and a pathway to Jabba. Now, Richard Greenaway, very excited about the possibilities of people basically doing the assassination run on Jabba. and also whether Jabba could be a fighter. It's more of a lover, I always thought. But
yeah, I agree.
He's a bully. So potential.
He is a bully.
Who's rocking HKs? I believe Alistair's got HKs.
It doesn't look like it.
Nope.
Where are the HKs? There's no HKs on
there. No, I'm flashing back to the semi-final. Sorry, that was Luke.
Right. The problem for me is that this blows my mind because the camera is looking the other way.
Yeah, we're looking, Alistair's on the left.
I should have flipped the camera. This is blowing my mind. Right, so Rich Parks, DV Scheme. Great card. Love it. Point. Have it every time. It's the lazy Imperial Assault player's card.
I'll try taking it.
Yeah, I don't.
The Gamorrean Guards, they're the stars on that list. They're the ones who do the heavy lifting. If you want anyone to go grab one man's trash,
they are horrendous.
It's your Gamorreans who do it, metaphorically.
They are horrendous.
They are great. No. It's funny because the normals are so bad.
The normals are terrible, yeah. But the elites are just immense. Well, no, I'm getting a shake there. I think they're good. Basically, I don't know what I'm talking about. The lack of surge. That's yes, their surge abilities are rubbish. A bit like Tuscans in that effect.
Yes.
Nothing much seems to be happening at the moment.
Nope. It's where you got extra, 45 minutes? 40
at least
minutes?
It's not a mirror match.
Yes.
Although there are double jabbers. Two jabbers.
Dave Burks has advocated the Elite Nexu for the jabber kill. That went around the WhatsApp group, didn't it? The Elite Nexu. And I'd do it, Dave.
Just on a side point, did anybody see Boba Fett today?
There was no Fett, no.
No Fett
not
at
13
all.
Points.
Yeah, but no fat. Diabolical.
Shiloh just makes it look a lot better.
And clothes. I tried at Nationals so hard to bring fat back, as in to encourage people, but no, they have failed in
so
that.
So here we have an elite Gamorrean heading up into one man's trash, into the trash compactor.
Still too far to pick one up though.
Ain't going
to
be able to hit anyone with his... Oh, he's going in. Go. Splash. So he's either going through it to get close to hit them, or he's going to start hauling crates.
I don't know what he's going to do.
No, we'd be mind readers if we really knew.
I don't think entirely think he knows what he's going to do. I mean, in the game he played against me, that hired gun on the bottom of the screen ran right up to claim that terminal. I moved a Bantha up, shot it, killed it one shot. It was an excellent play, I must say. My own play of the game.
Plans, what plans? He's making us up as he goes along.
I am. Who's he activating then?
End of round already.
There we go.
End of,
end of the round.
No points, no real damage done.
Just that Shiloh has taken 7.
Yeah, Shiloh's taken 7, yeah.
She can take another 5. Where is she?
Yeah, but she can heal one at the end of the start of the turn with her.
Yes, when she moves, so she's going to drop down to 6.
That would be Shiloh in your list.
I will target. Is it?
No
effects. Any
start
run
effects from you? No
start run
effects.
You could totally hear that.
Sound like Vader. Dave Pratt's going to be running his Boba soon. After
is
a
he?
Short break from IA. Is that short break going to last the year, Dave? After today.
Right, Rob, where are you? Get back on this stream.
What do you want me on the stream?
Sure, the TO, Rob, you've got to give us that kind of rules. Shiloh's making a move. Shiloh's making a move. That move is the fullback. Deathly hush falls over the room. Both players think. $1:25 on the clock. Still 20 minutes more than you get for your normal game. You can't just nod. That doesn't transmit well.
We should have turned the video on again.
You want to see the camera? Do you?
No,
switch back to Rob.
No, that's fine. That's fine. We do not need that.
There he is. Hi. He's ducked out of view. They're not here to see us, though.
No, definitely not.
That's the game. Here we go. We have a something as hands in the way. Can't quite see it. It's a Weequay Pirate. They've got quite a lot of range, and if you've got your Gamoran sat in the trash compactor, they are probably going to shoot you.
That's what we've got, so 4.
4 hidden.
Have we actually got range?
They have. Well, they get the auto surge if they're hidden, which I'm assuming they were. So, denies the surge, that stripped the range, I think. It takes some damage.
Yeah.
Pulls back. And he's going to repeat it with this one. Surge denied. So he's adding a surge for the hidden. Three damage to an extra surge. Range 4. One of the good things we can do with this gamma though is we can do this. I don't know, sorry, he was swearing. Oh, was that just Rob's face? Sorry, Dave, he is quite scary.
Tough luck away the result. One of appears, one of plus two.
That's a Gamorrean. Taking a Gamorrean, the first points on the board, Alice is up. However, the last game taught us anything, it's you can be up 9 points and still not win. I need him to update that scoreboard. Thank you very much. 5 points, there we go. So Rob, if you were running a list though, what would you have run? Would you have had a Jabba?
I'm not one to go with the latest releases.
The latest releases. But Rob does like large. I don't think the original 70s action figures have rules in the Imperial Assault, Rob. There we go. Thank you for the explanation for the weak ways in chat. That's very useful. Yes, you can't run your original figures, sadly.
Sadly not.
Hired guns, yeah or no? Come on. Settle an argument. I know Rich was experimenting with Greedo in his list before he went back to hired guns.
Hired guns, cheap and cheerful?
They're definitely cheap.
Definitely
Curtain Games, www.curtaingames.com. Discount War Game Store. Free UK postage and all orders over 20 quid.
30 quid.
30 quid, inflation, it happens. You really want to get in touch with us and, you know, your shopping with us enables us to run more events like this regional tournament. That's www.curtaingames.com. Can't think of a crate pun, but there's a crate on the move.
That's absolutely great.
We did the crate great.
Can you think of another one?
The Crate Wall of China. It's just meaningless, isn't it? Box, this box, yeah. Crates are like boxes. Boxing clever.
Let's not go down the box route.
Rob's wife puts his phone in a box every night so we can't get hold of him. Or is it a crate?
It's a box, definitely a box.
I'd really like to see someone just shunt Jabba forwards. I'm sorry. The crate escape, someone's gone for and chat. Well, that for me is the prize. If there was a prize, which there isn't. You got this dude here, Onar, in the middle, on the edge of the trash compactor. No defense dice, but pretty tanky. Can dish out some damage. Alistair may be a little bit laissez-faire in the quarterfinals. When we shunted him forwards, nearly lost him, but just about came through. Greedo lurking there, just on the left-hand side. He's blending in, as not to get shot.
These two are very much deep in thought. You can't see this, but...
Not us two. Just for reference, we'll go back to what we two look like. We're not deep in thought.
No.
But the players, if we had a player cam, you'd know that they're very much locked in, but they've got the extension, the extra time in the final allows you to think. But the Alliance range is just on the edge of the left-hand side. I mean, they've got a lot of range. They get the reroll on plus five. You should just say for the lawyers that any Star Wars music you may or may not be able to hear is entirely in your imagination. You are imagining it.
Neither of them are going to rush in and make an obvious mistake like that.
Trust your instincts, Rob. Trust your instincts, just go for it.
Are you talking about feeling the force?
Feeling the force. Mm. Feeling the force and doing it anyway.
We've already seen once that Rich moved his Gamoran guard forward, possibly a little bit recklessly.
You lost one.
Lost one is now.
I'm not sure what the gain was, but it could be a long, long-term plan.
If he does a special thing, he can do four spaces.
It's a bit of a joust, isn't it? You got your two squads. One will stand triumphant at the end; the other will not. Okay. And.
Alistair has got far more firepower at his disposal than Rich has.
Than a superstar destroyer. Yes, he does. Well, a lot of Rich's power comes from hitting stuff. And
yeah, and we're now in a situation where the doors are open over the trash compactor.
Very hard.
Nice,
very hard to close the ground.
Big fire arc.
Yep. And his characters excel at range.
Yeah.
Rich is now playing the mission.
You said he wasn't going to do that.
He looks like he's playing the mission now.
He's gone for plan B.
Yeah.
It's not a bad tactic, is it? If all else fails, play the mission.
It does force Alistair to react to him.
And Rob, as tournament organiser, you can answer this question. How many points for a crate?
Four.
You are a star.
No, I'm not.
Get the crates, you can't win the game, but you can go a long way towards it. And also, he's largely, because you've still got the one door open on the far side, he's largely got an on-opposed run to get those crates he's got out of their bag. Oh, bit of acrobatics there.
It is about dictating.
Here we go. Here's one of the Rebs.
The play now.
Rebel Rangers. It's got the range. He's going for the Gamorrean. Here comes the attack. It's a one pip defense. Surge and three.
We have the range. No question of that.
Here's the reroll. And steps back. Down goes the damage. Comes the next ranger. Got the line of sight. We're looking for five. Surge negated. Seven range, four damage.
Seven.
And steps back. And this is how he's got the range, so he's going to keep running
stepping
waves.
Forward,
yep.
Taking a pot shot.
I mean, they're 8 health ago, though, so there's quite a lot on them. They can tank a bit. But if you want to close with them and you want to get the, you know, the damage. So you've got one bit.
Again, range, no problem.
Can't pierce further this time. Is he dead? He is. Another Gamorrean.
Okay, done.
Are the scores being updated? Yep. Dave Perks just asked. Cool. Still 10 now for the two Gamorreans. Alistair's 10 points at Rob. So, is the game getting away from Rich?
No, because of the crate captures which are coming at the end of this turn. That will balance things out. But Rich's attempt at stealing the initiative, taking control of the game by going for the crates, is probably going to stall, because at this point Alistair's he's in a far better position. He can dictate the style of play, he can take the attack onwards.
And he's got access, in theory, to more crates than Rich has, plus the 10-point buffer. Here comes Vinto. Three viewers, well done. So the chat saying I don't see how Shyla and the pigs can make it happen at this point. That's probably my feeling as well. But I can't say it too loudly. Because they could hear me.
Change attacks,
maybe. Sorry, Rich. I kind of want you to win. But who knows? Jab is everywhere, yep, pretty much. But no one's played the combat jab yet. Cabba. Cabba for short. Jabba the hit. That's not a great one.
To be honest, I'm yet to see any jabber move outside the deployment zone.
Just give a spot prize to the first jabber that does it. He's locked in, isn't he?
Yeah.
Mm. He's not getting the spot prize.
Okay.
the other hall there sounds more and more like Mos Eisley Cantina. By the minute. I think Jabba could actually be in residence here tonight. Here come the hard guns. Got interactive dice box that we can.
Yeah,
it's nice. We get a nice kind of view. Checking those scores are still up to date. You reckon it's over?
I don't know.
The consensus, I think, in chat and here is that it's Alistair's to lose. But anything can happen with dice. I think what Rich needs to do is shunt Jabba forwards. The hero we need, not the hero we deserve.
He'll do his rush. 1, 2, 3, 4.
No, I don't think I've seen many others. I've seen regular a lot. Regular
push with a bump, taking a damage.
I don't think you're wrong. Sorry, anyone in chat who can't hear is Elite Alliance Rangers that Alistair's running. So underrated choice. I think we were all kind of nodding along. And last year Alistair ran Wingard and we all thought, no, they're no good. Oh, they're not going to win a tournament, but they did. So good players always find new tricks. That's a lot of dice there. Can we zoom in? CSI Angel.
Surge plus 2 damage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Assassinate.
And there goes the assassinate card.
Bang.
There's a pig. That's another few points. Alistair up 15-0 now. However, in the semi-finals, we saw a similar burning cards. When you got Jabba, your cards to burn, though. In theory,
I don't.
When I play, I just seem to draw nonsense, rubbish. Yeah, when you're 15 up as well, you can kind of...
No, it's always good just to get rid of the pigs, it seems.
Yeah. Take the pigs to the slaughterhouse. Come on, Rob, I'm looking for some awesome, insightful...
Keep looking. There we go, there goes the hard gun.
But from Hell's Heart, he stabs at thee. And doesn't do much. So he's 18 up now. I think we could be getting into flavour country. I think Alistair might be able to taste that trophy. Not that it's edible, but if it was.
Drawing 2.
Shyla's still up and about for Rich, mate.
Yes. 1. Yeah.
2.
I'll get 4 and you'll get 8.
And there go the crates.
He's off the mark.
So he's off the mark, yeah. But
Alistair tips it over to 22. He's got the option. I'll start ordering hits. He's got a few points out there. You can go for it.
Yeah. Take the damage. Look at a card. It is celebration.
Celebrate good times, come on.
And I have no more end of round effects. No end of round effects for me. Any start of round effects from you, sir? Any from you first? I have no start of round effects. I'll try and take a condition. You will have it, sir. And you'll see high points for that?
She just
fucking got it. Yeah, I normally put it on the cards.
Jabba. That's my name, Jabba. He's not listening to him. He's not.
We all will at chat room if we all say it at once.
Rich is going to have to pull something out of the bag.
But what? Oh, here he goes. Onar. Onar's coming. Lots of dice.
Can we zoom in there?
Yep.
So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 damage. 2 surge.
Okay. So yep. I will not apply it on a special effect. And we'll fall 8 damage. 8 puts me in 10.
Up to 8 with the surges.
Then I'm going to play
10.
So that's 8 and 10 on 8 now. He's got the opportunity to kind of pop out now.
Okay. I'll go with Onar. With his 10 health, 5 health left. 1, 2, 3.
Oh, so that's the Mandalorian whip on, and Onar on the attack.
1, 2, 3. Picks up the way.
But he collects the crate.
Oh, I got the crate, yeah.
When that crate goes over, we're looking at it.
It's 5 in total. And he hasn't used his...
26. Shana won't be there much longer. Look at this. We've got an expert coming up now. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, joining me now, I'll let him introduce himself, Luke.
National
finalist. Beaten semi-finalist today, but most importantly, the man who stopped me making the cut by destroying me in game 5. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm very good, Tim. Yeah.
I'm grand. I mean, talking out to a handful of people and a dog. Nonsense. But no, yeah, good, thanks. And so how do you see this game going?
At the moment, I've got the problem is the list which is running is got that big open gap. They both opened the doors. Yep. And I don't know if that was probably Rich's thing, that I would have probably gone for that middle door.
Okay.
Because of the damage. Now, he's obviously had to use attacks. If he... and it's always that, but it gives Alistair, especially with those rangers, that complete open field right through the middle and down to the on the diagonal down to the bottom terminal.
Well, he's got the range, hasn't he? The range is limited. Yeah. That was just OBS restarting. There we go. We're back on.
Oh, there we go.
Apologies, chat.
But the blue dice is normally not that great. But when you've got some really good surge abilities on there, the +2 damage and the 7 health, it's just it is something to chew through.
Yes.
So 21 health for the 3 figures, I think, has become a. It was very hard. These are the 2 people I've lost to today. I've lost both to Rich and to Alistair, so they were my 2 losses. And I think that was the bit I underestimated, that I should have dealt with them sooner, but they require so many extra shots that you're losing activations.
So if you could have your time again, how would you counter them?
I don't know. I think that was the problem. I don't think I had the complete answer. I dealt with what I could deal with, but I kind of had to mix and match, and I probably needed to focus on them sooner. Mm-hmm. And I played the Dianoga, so it was this map, but with the Dianoga in the middle against Alistair. And I probably should have just, because we were trading shots and he was trading probably better, is I might have just focused on the Dianoga to try and rack up extra points.
Okay.
But it was very good. That was an absolutely close game and hilarious in the end. But then, so was Rich, and I think that was my mistake again against Rich, was I dealt with the uniques, and the Gamorrean guards were pretty much untouched. I only dealt with one of them, and he had 3 running around, able to kind of go, well, I can do whatever I want.
Yeah, we saw that kind of in the semi-final, actually. They dictate the game.
Yeah.
Once you give them that space, and once they hit your lines as well.
Yeah.
And if you can kind of keep that distance at the moment, like us is doing very well, you know, big gaps, they're not going to get in your face and start cleaving up. But once they're there.
Yeah.
can be hard to shake him.
I find the cleave not as useful, but the fact that you can... Right, on that red dice, you know there's a third of a chance it's going to be three.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other...
The reroll.
You've got a reroll, but it's nothing... the best bit is, right, okay, it's a 1 in 6, that it's a 1. The rest of it's all 2 plus.
Yes.
So you've got an average of always 4 damage. And it's like, right, and that, 4 damage, and then if you get that 4 and you reroll it, you're likely to get the 5 or 6 or a surge. And it's like, yeah, try and deal with that. It does build up, but they've got to get there.
So we've got the Rangers going for the hard gun. I'm assuming. Nope, he's pulled.
Got it. You've seen a lot of jabbers today.
An awful lot of jabbers.
I think he's obviously made a good impact on the scene. I do like what he's done for the Scum.
Yeah, they kind of needed a focus, didn't they? I mean, he offers something, doesn't he? Both theme and abilities that they didn't have before, which is always good.
And it's nice to see a different type of ability. The fact that it's just a draw a card, it's not in Rebels, it's not in Imperials, it's something very different.
Yes, yeah. Gives it a bit of flavour.
Yeah, works well.
Stream should be running. It says we're live. Anyone in the chat room who can't see, it'd be a good idea to let me know, because it's hard to know. It's a bit silent. It looks to be running over here. That's good. It's running live. I'm watching it at the moment. Maybe just restart. Yeah, we had a reboot on the hardware. But anyone, ATT now watching, anyone in the stream who can't see it, just give it a restart, get back in. I'll do some more plug-in now, so I don't know if you've got anything you want to plug, Luke. We always like a bit of sponsorship, but Curtain Games.
I was about to say, I will give Curtain Games full props. I met James when he ran the Nationals,
okay,
and he was brilliant there. And then because of that, I have made the trip. Now I'm from Dover way, so this is a 4-hour trek for me.
Blimey. Should be back up. But it is recording, so even if you can't see it now, you'll get it on YouTube, and it'll be in its complete state, the way it was designed to be seen.
So, I'm interested, because it was looking at the command cards. There's a few command cards that I've seen today that have probably made a big resurgence, like Celebration was one that was often not taken.
Okay.
Mainly because it was like, well, it was a naught, but you had to kill a unique. And there weren't that many uniques. And with the new system and the new pointing of, well, when you kill a model, great, you get some points. And you've got more uniques back in the game. And Celebration's become a very strong card again.
I like Celebration. I just never managed to get it to work like I want it to.
Well, it's because that's the hard point, because you're normally trying to hunt high wound models or they've got some tricks up their sleeve. The only ones that you can normally see it very easily on is, unfortunately, like Onar. Because, well, you can shoot him and he's not going to stop it.
It's good. We're going to have to just stop the stream again. We're still down, so... Do you want to... Yeah, it could be. Do you want to pause the game?
Not really.
Nope. Going to come back up. Right, guys, we're coming back up, so... Apologies for that. It's been one of those things when you're not in your shop or whatever, and we've got to try and improvise as best we can to get the stream to come up.
So,
stay up. So it's a bit of a challenge, but we try our best, and apologies for anyone, but it will be in YouTube in its entirety as soon as we can get it. So don't worry, it's going to say it's offline, but it will be coming back up. I've got to get into the chat room now. So whilst we wait, we are back.
So,
Alice is up 26-17. Not insurmountable, is it, Luke?
No, it's come back, because considering you had that earlier 22-8 swing, it means obviously figures are now coming off from both sides. And looking at the damage, it's starting to spread out. But we've obviously got that hard bit that there's still that uphill struggle where you've lost figures, you've lost some of your activations that seems to be on Richard's side. But if you look, obviously Alistair's now lost 2. And it kind of makes a big difference.
And you've got Shyla. Shyla, somehow, I mean, she's been playing a little bit defensively. She's still hanging on there. She's got 7 points. She's got another 5 to go.
Well, and the thing is, this is a longer game, and she can recover her health every turn if you
need to. Yep, so moves, activation, sorry, can either take a point of movement, point of health. She's a bit of a tank.
She can be. I think the big thing I found, and I've played Nationals Final, and I've played another Regionals Final, the extra time limit used to be a very big game changer. I wasn't obviously that keen on it, I'll be honest,
yep.
because it changes the way the game plays, because you had a lot more time.
Hmm.
It meant that if you had lists that could regenerate, you'd run away more.
Yes,
just to get that health back, which then meant you could hide and then bring it back in, and it changes the way the game plays. Where it's normally a very fast-paced, brutal, here's my abilities or cards, and you're trying to eliminate stuff, all of a sudden it's like, oh right, well, I might lose this medal and I've got a way of bringing it back, so, oh, there's a big dice roll.
Let's have a look at that. Oh, what is on the dice roll? Oh no, wrong camera. It's great when it works, it really is, but then when it doesn't work, it's a
We need some color. So there's a big lot there now, but this is where. There you go. That's the 40.
That's it. That's the 40. It's over.
Yeah, Shyla
just
died.
Well, I'm glad you. Jabba's not taking any punishment today. Shyla's gone.
But yeah, it's coming down to now. Obviously, with the new change in the rules, the extra time doesn't play as much, because you kill a miniature, you're still getting the points straight away. And it used to be that if you had reinforcements or whatever, they would run away, rebuild the unit, and come back in, and you've not got those 9 points or whatever. And that's what I think has changed it so much for the better.
Yes, yeah, I agree. I think it's well. That's it, Luke.
We're done.
It happened so quickly.
Yeah,
done. Almost weren't ready. It's all over.
Now they've both got a pretty trophy.
Yes, so they're going to be talking about it on that desk mic. I think I'm going to hand over to them and go to the tabletop mic, guys. So thanks for sticking around, thanks for listening. Tune in next time we do an event, and I'll go and try and grab a word from the players now. Bye. Against the Rangers list, particularly with the new Rangers, might maybe need to drop.
Oh, okay, sure.
And Tim's going to come over and.
Right, Charles.
Yeah.
Oh. You've done it again. Just never stop winning.
It's the lucky shirt.
Commiserations, Rich.
Thank you. Tom, again, a very good match. It's a real pleasure, as ever. It always
is. Let's free the shackles of the dice count, Frank.
Two of these, me and the other two are yours.
Thank you.
I've got three of these. Oh, four of these, because I got that one that's the one that's come missing.
Yeah.
One in special, one in a special, two, three special greens.
So guys, I'm going to have a... I know you're
packing
up and it's tiring and stuff.
Oh, it's fine.
That's okay.
But I'm going to basically point this camera at you.
Yep.
And then I'm going to point it at Rich afterwards. Just want to have a chat about the game, how it went. So you asked how to go. Speak into this snowball mic.
Oh, okay.
And I'm going to check you're in, but just take us through it.
Yeah. I think what Rich and I have talked about a lot is sort of play patient, play safe, try to make your opponent do more and work harder for what you want to give him. So after I lost initiative, I knew that I was going to have to make his round two ineffective, if I could. And that's hard, because he's going to start and come out with a really big hit. I got lucky, though, because we're looking at the all this blue territory and doors in the way. So my start of the game was just keep those doors closed if I could, and keep the swamp water between us. Try to take advantage of my range. And I think that really played out. I think that the Rangers being able to hot shot that Gamorrean was a real momentum dictator for the game, and it made it hard to turn it around. I think the Alliance Rangers are super valid. Andy Brazier told me they were good. I was poo-pooing them, but the free Pierce one and that reliable double blue with the reroll. Here's the trick about them. I think I figured out. If you have to shoot at five, you're staying five away from your opponents, which is pissing them off too. So. That's why I think they're really good.
Cool. Thanks. Well, thanks, Alistair. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much.
Sadly, Rich, this means I have to turn to you and say, what went wrong?
I think I was always going to find this difficult. I think there's two ways that I could approach this, and I tried both on this map today. So the first one is to charge everything down one or the other of the corridors. And I tried that earlier, ended up being forced down here, and I couldn't get anything in round two, so I had to run in and jam, and I lost that game. That was my loss through Swiss. So when I saw the map come up again, I just thought, right, I've got to have a different plan here. That didn't work.
Fighting the last battle.
And I thought, So I thought, right, I'll try and get the crates. I think I've got a decent player. If I can get the smugglers around here, pull a couple of those crates in with the Gamorreans pushing past them. Then I've got a decent play to get three, four of the crates, and then maybe I can make a game of it with those 12, 16 points. But it turns out they were pretty much the only points that I got because I just didn't have, because I've come back, I didn't have the time then to get back in, and his ranged units just picked me apart. I agree on the Alliance Rangers with the PS1 is nice against any PS against the Gamorreans is good. Craig, you are an absolute fool.
he's giving you some compliments and, you know, congratulatory stuff on here.
You have to know, I haven't given the scoring dial away already to anybody who is not you. And
camera adds £12. I think
that's
harsh.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh. Okay, well, on that box, Alistair, if you just want to pick up that trophy and kind of go at the camera with it.
I think I've got to give this trophy as a co-victory to me and my man Onar. I don't think people see him coming, and his bump off the terminal. Well, I wish he was painted, but...
maybe give him a paint job, though.
Well, maybe he deserves
a paint job, I think.
He deserves a paint job after that performance, just like Greedo was my my other hitter, so...
Well, very good. Well, who's left? We'll give him a half round of applause, anyway.